Okay, I'm testing out a thing here. I just set the motherboard BIOS to auto for most things. Auto voltage, auto turbo ratios, and all that. Auto load line calibration. And I'm running Prime 95 with small FFTs to generate all the heat, which actually isn't going to be all that much because I'm delidded. I have a copper heat spreader. So, yeah, I'm not sure this is really going to do anything amazing. But what I'm hoping happens is these sensors give out while I'm doing this video recording, so you're just gonna sit here with me for a bit. What I'm hoping happens is this starts giving me crap that doesn't make any sense. It's not gonna get hot. But I don't think heat has anything to do with it. Random thing. I don't really ever record on my phone in 1080p, but wow, I guess because it records in a smaller frame size, it's able to use more of the image sensor for the video stabilization because this is pretty still. Anyway. I love this phone. Good phone. It's a pretty low V-core. Man, this is just like room temperature. Look at this. Well, I mean, it's not. I'm kind of being facetious. But for this being small FFTs in Prime 95, yeah, it's really cool. Four minutes in, 4 minutes out. How long am I gonna let it do this? Well, I really don't know. If I record too long of a video, the phone takes a while to actually close the video, which is really annoying. I've lost video due to that before. I kind of wish it didn't use MP4s and he used like FLVs or something. How's the computer doing? Let's take a look at the computer. What are you doing in there? Everything good? You having fun? You're just calculating data to cook yourself. How do you feel about that? Like, there's no purpose to what you're doing right now. Yeah, he's fine with it. He's just like, oh, I got things to compute. I'm a computer. I think it's gonna do it. Can't focus that close. What are you, a wuss? Huh? Focus. Yep. Kind of bored just sitting here. I kind of want to fuck with stuff while it's doing this. Cause like everything's safe in terms of voltages and stuff, and temperatures. What's happening here? Let's see. I wanna see what's going on here. I'm gonna see what I wanna see. Okay. What should I mess with while it's doing this? Hmm. Trollstope. Throttlestap. My name's Throttlestap. What's this set at? 8 to 44. Oh, this is already changing things on me. Well, we might just see a crash now that I open this. How many volts is it giving? 1.2. It's not. You're not doing anything that I like. Oh boy. Oh, don't do that. Don't do that, by the way. Don't do that. Well, I don't think it was gonna actually give the error that I want. So let's change our tune here. So let's go over how I got this set up. Hey, look at the screen. Thank you. Let me get my little desk light out of the lens's way here. Here's all the settings. You gotta adhere to your set and your setting. That should be good, right? Right. Let's check out voltages. 0.425, sure, why not? Okay, and that's enough of that. And save and exit. Do that same exact thing, but this time we're all gonna go to hell. Okay, now this is what everybody in the world is talking about these days. Is it hot enough for you? Look at that. Ain't that something? I guess, maybe. Just ignore me, I'm trying to frame the video square to these windows for no particular reason other than I can.
Look at that.
You're gonna cause electromigration and degradation of the chip silicon. It's not gonna last 5 years if you run it at that voltage. Well, I'm gonna replace it. Probably whenever the new chip comes out. I wouldn't mind a 12 or a 16 core, 12 or 16 thread Coffee Lake with 128 megabytes of DRAM. I'd like that. Me Broadwell Lake. Wow, we're at 17 minutes in. Hasn't this been fun? I would normally just be doing this anyway. How hot do you think the VRM is going to get? Let me change the max on this. And this one too. Here you go, 9,000. You like that, huh? Huh? What temperature is my room right now? Because that's relevant to this. Yeah. Just 70. It feels so much hotter, I don't know why. Maybe it's because I'm next to a really hot computer. Grabbing this guy. That heat sink, that's 37, the top one. I just can't aim in there. Maybe that's just my problem in life. Nothing's actually hot. There's no such thing as temperature. I want to buy a Fleur. Yeah, that still checks out. That's still good. That's still moving. The other one looks good. I was just wondering because the CPU, motherboard CPU sensor was flat. I was getting worried. We're at 20 minutes and 40 seconds now. Maybe all of a sudden it's fine. Let's stop that exit and Asus RealBench. Let's move everything over a little bit here. So I'm gonna put that on stress test. And I'm going to be able to see that this says words. Maybe this will do something. This also gets your GPU involved in things. Package power, say. That's fine. That's fine. Fine. Okay. How much RAM is it using? Should be all of it. Gonna try it. Whoa. Gonna blink. That usually means there's a...
Oh! My cache. Bobby.
Cool. I'm not entirely sure why System 3 isn't going up. I'm sure I have that set to be controlled by the CPU. And those are 2,000 RPM fans. So, CPU and System 1. CPU is obviously what's on there. That's System 1. That's System 3. And you can't see System 2 / VRM because it's in there. Oh. Cool. Well, I guess I could see how those fans are set up. I won the game. Okay. You won the game. You lost the game. No. See? Ah, come on. Come on, Jack. Get it together. Yep, that's right. That's right. Okay, everything's good. Let's just do this. 50. Give it the 50s. And boom. And boom, boom. Oh, so 30 minutes is a long, rambling time that we're having here. I'm wondering if it's because I don't have the Gigabyte software installed. Could find that out. I'm gonna install it and I'll be back. Cool. So I'm gonna install the App Center because you need the App Center to install the rest of the crap. So we're gonna launch App Center. And it's down here. Go click that button to check for updates. And I'll rest my shoulder right here. And we need this update. I need to find something to lock the exposure to. That. How about that? Sure, why not? You know, just live your life, why don't you? Just, you know, do stuff to people. Okay, it wants me to restart, so I will. Going on this journey together. Journey to madness, really. Insanity, all sorts. My name is Oris. I moonlight as an eagle. I'm a raptor of some sort. I love Gigabyte, because I am a bird. I have LEDs in my talons.
Listen to me roar. Mm.
I mean, you really don't need to do this. Please stop. Thank you. Okay. I'm actually, I don't care. I'm gonna let it do that. So right now I'm putting it in system monitor mode. It takes a second to load up over here. Come on. I believe in you. Okay, thank you. Thank you. You're nice. Now the whole thing with running that, it'll make sure it won't happen. So actually, let's close it. So I know it's installed, and if I look at the screen and not the phone, I could go here and there should be EasyTune engine service, which is running. And there's a couple others like G service. There's a whole bunch of gigabyte crap that it puts on here. And we're going to do real bench. And just in case, I'm gonna also have Prime Mighty Bow go in here. Stress test. Start. You out of my way. You. We're gonna go nuts here. I fear nothing. Cool. I just froze it. Oh, it's back. It's back. Guys, it's back. Oh, it's frozen again. Oh, man, I'm really hurting it. It's crying. Come on, come back. If nothing happens during this, then it's fixed, and I don't know why. There goes Prime 95, I think. Or maybe that was something in Real Bench. Nope, we got our first Windows error. There we go. Come on. I just want Prime going now. Come on, I'm getting impatient with you. It's just like computer problems to not manifest themselves when you want them to, isn't it? My foot's asleep. Ow.
Wiggle.
Sorry. Hmm. The watts am I using?
Ooh, the ability to read that is hard. Okay. Works for me.
I'm going to try one more thing. So this is the last thing I'm going to try. I put load line calibration on extreme instead of turbo. And now we got Cinema 4D open with my little stress test scene that I made. It's fun. It's a good scene. So let's make it a little smaller so I can fit it. And settings. Using progressive physical renderer, so it just constantly hammers. QMC, global illumination, ambient occlusion. Go. What kind of voltage are we going to see now? Not much different. It's not as hot as Prime. But it's up there. But I mean, there's a little bit more real world than running Prime. Who sits around running Prime 95 all day? This is a long ass video. Ass video. Videos of ass. Just for shits, I'm gonna get my GPU involved in this by running Folding at Home. Should be working. That's weird. Cinema 4D was using up too much CPU to try to get folding. There you go. Now folding is kind of going. Almost there. There you go. Let's actually change this. Oh, we're hammering the CPU, hammering the GPU. We're using 400 and let's call it 475 watts. Here, I'll actually
prove it. Prove my data.
Hey, focus, you fuck.
So you buy it.
Got about 10 minutes to make this happen. So I think I'm going to stop that, don't save that, pause folding, exit. Right click, quit, keep that going, and we're going to end with 15 minutes, yeah, 15 minutes of real bench. Then I'm going to get back to my article, review, paper, thingamajig on memory overclocking on the system. Man, I'm thirsty. Yeah, so real bench, you know, runs on the GPU here. Does a whole bunch of handbrake and compressing files. I think I notice sometimes it does that. And then when it's done with a run, it tests like the hash of the output to see if it's a valid run. So that should be good. And this is using 426 watts of total system power. Oh, finally, there it is. There it fucking is. And I doubt that this video will save. But this gives me an opportunity to launch App Center. Stop the stress test. So let me just focus over here. So I'm launching the system information viewer. As you can see, it fixed it. All of the sensors are back to where they're supposed to be. So yeah, cool. Awesome.